The U.S. dedicates nearly 13% of its annual primary energy consumption to heating, treating, and moving water. Of that amount, nearly 25% was used for heating water in the residential sector. In addition to its large energy demand, water heating is a large source of residential greenhouse gas emissions. The majority of water heating units in the U.S. consume natural gas, electricity, or petroleum, which have carbon dioxide emissions on site or at the source. Taking these points together, switching water heating technologies could potentially reduce energy consumption and greenhouse gas emissions in a non-trivial way. This analysis investigates the energetic and environmental trade-offs of water heating in 27 regions of the contiguous United States, taking into account variations in regional electricity mixes, climate, policy incentives, and fuel prices. Nationally, about 50% of water heating units are fueled by natural gas at the point of use. Another 40% of water heaters are electric, and a small proportion of water heaters are fueled by petroleum-derived fuels, such as liquid petroleum gas and fuel oils. These distributions vary considerably by region, as shown in this diagram. This Sankey diagram shows the primary energy consumed for water heating in the U.S. It shows the energy losses from water heating, which are significant. The thickness of the flows from left to right are proportional to the amount of energy consumed. In the diagram, we see that the majority of natural gas is consumed on-site in the commercial or residential sectors. A much smaller fraction is delivered to a power plant and converted into electricity that is then delivered to water heaters in our buildings and homes. Electric water heaters generally have end-use efficiencies of 90% or more. However, when the losses at the power plant are considered, the efficiencies are much worse. Typical power plants have an efficiency of about 33%. That means a typical electric water heater plugged into a typical power plant has about 30% end-to-end efficiency overall. Natural gas water heaters, by contrast, are generally 60% efficient at end use, but have very little upstream losses in terms of processing and delivering the natural gas resource. Consequently, natural gas water heaters are actually more energy efficient when all energy losses are considered, even though electric water heaters have a higher site energy efficiency. The takeaway is that it's important to consider all energy losses when making appliance purchases. Unfortunately, federal energy factors only consider the end-use efficiency of a device and do not include the losses at the power plant in the case of electric water heaters. Considering carbon emissions requires a more detailed analysis, as the type of fuels that are used for power generation vary regionally. The primary fuels include carbon-intensive sources such as coal and petroleum, to carbon-free sources such as renewable and nuclear energy. To quantify the energy and emissions associated with water heating, we assessed water heating performance in 27 regions of the contiguous U.S., including 17 individual states as well as 10 clusters illustrated here. This figure differentiates the primary energy consumed for water heating by region. The primary energy embedded in on-site electricity consumption is summarized in blue, on-site natural gas consumption in orange, and on-site LPG and fuel oil in red and yellow, respectively. Electricity mixes vary as shown. Some electricity mixes are coal-intensive, as shown by the proportion of electricity colored in black, while some mixes have a larger proportion of natural gas colored in orange, renewables colored in blue, or nuclear colored in green. Regional water heating emissions tend to be highest in cold states that have coal-intensive electricity mixes, such as Indiana and Ohio, and least intensive in warm states with emissions-lean electricity mixes, such as the hydropower-rich Pacific Northwest. Based on these insights, we then sought to understand how regional emissions would change under various technological shifts for water heaters. First, we assessed how regional emissions would change if 10% of each region's water heating fleet shifted from electric to natural gas water heating. Regions with large fractions of coal power generation that switched from electric to natural gas water heating saw the largest emissions reductions. By contrast, regions with very clean electricity mixes actually had net increases in carbon emissions, as their average electricity generation mixes emitted less carbon than burning natural gas on site. Next, we assessed how regional emissions would change if 10% of each region's water heating fleet shifted from electric to solar hot water heating with an electric backup. As would be expected, net electricity consumption was reduced in each region when a uniform shift to solar water heating was imposed. However, states with very coal-intensive electricity generation and very low solar resources actually saw larger carbon reductions when they shifted to natural gas water heating than to solar water heating, since their electric backup unit had to run often when the sun was not shining. This analysis points to the importance of water heating as an opportunity to comply with energy efficiency priorities and to the importance of considering regional variation in energy efficiency strategies. Results indicate that federal energy factor metrics aim to inform consumers about the environmental performance of residential end-use appliances are often insufficient in leading consumers towards the least energy and carbon-intensive technology. This phenomenon is especially true in comparing natural gas and electric appliances, since energy factors do not capture large energy losses upstream of the point of use. Developing metrics that reflect the source efficiency of an appliance would provide more useful information regarding the energy use characteristics of common household technologies. Overall, reducing electric water heating prompted large carbon reductions in regions with coal-intensive electricity mixes. Whether these states benefited more by switching to natural gas or solar water heaters depended on the solar resources in the region. States with low solar resources and carbon-intensive power generation generally had smaller relative carbon reductions by shifting to solar water heaters, since the electric backup had to run a larger fraction of the year.